great. Well, the choice that I had, the one I picked out, it's something that's very close to me. I've loved it for a really long time. And it's staying for tonight, it's Stagefright, so I'd like to share it with you guys. I picked The Raven by Edgar Allan Poe.
I didn't know you picked The Raven.
Yeah, I picked The Raven. You remember when you said you wanted this to be like a surprise that we would...
Yeah, that's kind of an awesome idea, but I also picked The Raven.
Well, we can still do this. You want me to do like half the things to go to half?
Nah, you go ahead. I'll just wait until next year and enjoy Halloween.
Well, it's kind of a long poem here. You want to, I can read half. It's longer than people remember. I can half the other half.
I wasn't so much going to read it as I was going to reimagine it.
Boo!
I don't know what that means.
You know, like, modernize it, update the story. I went into the Raven's backstory, figured out why it was the way it was, why it did what it did. It was a big extravagant stage show, class, and pride, and pyrotechnics. But, you know, reimagine.
That sounds really stupid, man.
No, dude, it's fucking awesome. But go ahead, I'm not really pissed now. They are.
Oh, wait, you said you wanted to read that first, right?
Yeah.
Oh. Okay, how about you act it out and all that reads? Is that right?
Yeah, if you help me, it's a two-man show.
That's all right.
Whatever.
Yeah. Alright, don't fuck this up. Gently do costume. That's a real knife. Make sure it brings real emotion.
Alright.
Oh, I need you over there. You're not blocking me.
Are you guys ready?
Once upon a midnight dreary, while I pondered, weak and weary, over many a quaint and curious volumes of forgotten lore, while I nodded nearly nagging, suddenly there came a tapping, as someone gently rapping at my chamber door. "Tis some visitor," I muttered, "tapping at my chamber door, only this, and nothing more." Ah, distinctly I remember, it was the bleak December.
Man, it's fucking cold outside.
Any dying ember rot its ghost upon the floor. Eagerly I wish tomorrow, vainly I sought the sorrow. From my books there ceased of sorrow for the lost Lenore.
Lenore! Lenore!
Nameless, and here forevermore.
Lenore! I miss you, boo.
And the silken satin certain rustling of each purple curtain filled me with fantastic terrors never felt before. So that now, to still the beating of my heart, I stood repeating, "Tis some visitor entreating entrance at my chamber door."
Young plumber, who's there? I have a shotgun.
Presently my soul grew stronger, hesitating then no longer. "Sir," said I, "or madam, truly your forgiveness I implore, but the fact is I was not
young plumber, I was sleeping."
And so faintly came tapping at my chamber door. That I scarce, I sure I heard you. Then I opened wide the door, darkness filled, and nothing more.
All right. Syndic. Or the guest appearance from the hills, Warren Conrad.
Jim, did you bring something at least that we can do?
What? I said we were, I want to do the Raven.
John, or?
I'm done. This is it. Okay. That's fine. Alright, we're gonna do zombie stuff. Then